I'm Colin.
And I'm Harrison.
And we are the BCI Guys. After 9 lessons and 19 videos, this video series has come to an end. But your neurotechnology journey certainly does not have to. We hope that we provided you with a broad enough overview to gain a greater understanding of the field. Neurotechnology is inherently multidisciplinary. Whether you like working with software or hardware, you're a neuroscientist, more of a business person, or just a hobbyist looking to stay up to date with cutting-edge technology, there are multiple resources available to help you find your way.
If you are looking to get started with more affordable consumer devices, we recommend taking a look at eMotive, Muse, OpenBCI, and G-Tech. OpenBCI and G-Tech both engage a lot with their communities. OpenBCI, as the name suggests, provides all of their hardware and software open source and have generated a passionate following. G-Tech offers a yearly summer school program that gives students an intensive 5-day neurotech crash course, among many other initiatives.
If you're interested in keeping an eye on the industry, check out Neurotech Reports for business analysis and the Brain-Computer Interface Technologies book series by Springer, which summarizes important research findings.
If you have an idea of your own, whether it is a hacker, student, or research project, submit your findings to the annual BCI Awards.
There are tons of conferences and events that cover neurotech and its derivatives as well. The BCI Society hosts a yearly conference which, quote, bring together scientists, engineers, and clinicians involved in BCI research and clinical use to review the present state of the field, address key issues critical to further progress, and promote the education and participation of young researchers.
If you want a textbook to advance your knowledge from this course, we recommend picking up the book Brain-Computer Interfacing, An Introduction by Rajesh P.N. Rao.
As we have maintained throughout this course, we have not been compensated in any way by the above companies and organizations. We just think that there are some great resources to get started. We regret that we can't cover all of the amazing resources that are out there, so we will include an ever-updating list below this video.
Of course, one of the best things you can do right now is join the NeurotechX community. In their words, NeurotechX is a nonprofit organization whose mission is to facilitate the advancement of neurotechnology by providing key resources and learning opportunities and by being leaders in local and worldwide technological initiatives. NeurotechX has the largest community of neurotech enthusiasts in the industry. It includes students, professors, and private hobbyists all working together to advance the field of neurotechnology. NeurotechX and its student groups have produced hundreds of hours of content for you to sift through. Make sure to check out their Slack group, which is full of information about local chapters and online or in-person NeurotechX events.
Thank you so much for taking this journey with us to the realm of neurotechnology. We wanted to give a special thanks to NeurotechX for their support in making this video series possible, to the Rochester Institute of Technology for providing us with equipment and a production facility, and to our production team, Michael Abbott for editing videos, Sam Nix for on-set support, and Ryan Wellens for handling set direction, lighting, and filming.
Thank you to our writers and content validators, Leonardo Farisi, George Cassis, Asa Chamble-Jacobs, and Paige Trottier.
And of course, a very special thanks to the Human Encyclopedia, Forrest Schuster of ARG Zero Technologies, for his extensive help in script writing, audio engineering, and content writing. Finally, a huge thanks to Dr. Dan Phillips for getting the ball rolling.
We hope to see you in the brain-controlled future.